Hi, this is Jen Lasser with Adobe Analytics Product Management. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create a table of contents from scratch and share it out to all of your end users. What you're viewing here is an example of a six-panel table of contents. We've organized it by different themes that are important to our business users. We have themes like marketing channels, different team dashboards, different dashboards related to KPIs, even some related to our mobile app property. So to start creating the table of contents, you actually want to start from a blank project. On the blank project, the first thing you want to do is add a text box. So in our visualization rail, you can drag over text. In the text box, you want to jot down all of the different projects or visualizations that you want to link to in your table of contents. For example, if we're doing a marketing channel themed panel, we'll go ahead and list out all the different marketing channel dashboards that we offer. Once you have a list of the different things that you want to link to, go ahead and give your panel a name. This is the theme. And then start collecting the links that you want to hyperlink into this panel. So to do that, you have a few different options. The three options are, one, link to a project under Share, Get Project Link. If you haven't saved your project before, it'll quickly prompt you to save. And then it'll populate a short URL for you. You can simply copy this and use it to hyperlink in your table of contents. So that'll be a link to a full project, but you can also link to individual panels or visualizations within the project as well. To do that, you want to right-click on the visualization header, and you can say Get Visualization Link. Or you can right-click on the panel header and say Get Panel Link. These links will take a user to the exact part of the project that you're wanting to link to. So once you have your links collected, you can go back to your new project where you started jotting down your list of things that you want to build a table of contents for. And then you can select the first value in the text box, choose hyperlink from the rich text editor, and simply paste in the link that you copied. When that's selected, it'll take a visitor or a user of this table of contents to that exact project that you've linked them to. A couple last things that you can do before you start building out more themes is first, shrink your panel so that you can fit more panels into one screen. You can also optionally bring in a visualization if you'd like to show what the data will look like when they land in each of these projects or visualizations. Keep in mind when you do that, the visualization will show for the report suite that this project is being built in. The links themselves, however, do not need to be based in this single report suite. They can be sourced from any report suite where the project was initially built. So if you repeat this process several times, you'll end up with a table of contents like we shared at the beginning. The last thing that you want to do after your table of contents is built is share it out with your end users. You can do this by going to Share, Share Project, and from here you can type in as many recipients as you'd like. The other thing that you want to do before you share it is check the Set as Landing Page for Recipients box. By selecting this Set as Landing Page option, it'll make it a lot easier for your users who access analytics to find the projects they need and get to the analysis and insights that they want much faster.